When I moved to the UK, some of my Scottish relatives told me I needed to get into whisky tasting. Honestly, I was unsure. I had tried whisky before, but it was never really my cup of tea. As someone that is opening a brewery, I know that there's a lot that goes into creating whisky. After all, they've kept this in a barrel for 10 years. That's a long time to store something. I had to therefore go around Scotland and visit the distilleries and see what makes this so special. And here's what I learned. For a spirit to be called Scotch whisky, it needs to be made in Scotland. It then can only use malted barley, water, and yeast. So they're quite simple ingredients, but they manage to change the flavors through putting it in oak casks, adding different cereal malts to give it different colors. They then have to barrel age it for a minimum of 3 years, and most whiskey distilleries will do 10 plus years. You'll see some like going up 40, 50 years, which is a sane amount of time to keep some spirits in a barrel, but that's why they're worth a lot of money. So then the spirit can either be a single malt or a blended malt. So the distilleries can blend some of their different whiskies together, or they might blend it with another distillery. However, if it's been in the same barrel, it is a single malt whiskey. Now that we know the basics of whiskey, you have to learn how to taste it. So if you visit any distillery on your visit through Scotland, they will run you through how to do this like a pro. Here's my basic run through for you. First, you need the glassware. So it's kind of like a sherry glass, but it doesn't have the stem. And this is so that you can swirl the whiskey and sniff the whiskey. So it's designed perfectly so that you can get all the smells and aromas come through. Also, it stops you like throwing whiskey to your next neighbor across or on yourself, which is always a bonus. So at any tasting event, you'll generally find these glasses. Now, I'm no pro at tasting whiskey, but there are three steps. There is the smell, palate, and taste. So you start off with swirling your whiskey, smelling it, and then taking a small sip, but keeping it in your mouth so you get the palate. And then drinking it so you get the taste that goes down your throat. And through these different phases, it should give you the journey through the whiskey. So think of the start, middle, and end through the whole process. So the smell is the start, the palate is the middle, and the end of the story is the taste. You should be able to taste things like, is it soft? Is it hot? Is it drying so it has some tannins? Or is it refreshing? Or is it lively? Can you pick up any of the sweetness? And then after swirling the whiskey, what are you left with? Is it short, medium, or long? Dry or smooth? Are there new flavors that you have tasted while swallowing it? Now that you know how to taste whiskey, you need to grab a fellow enthusiast, travel companion, or whoever is going on this Scottish adventure with you to one of the whisky regions. There are over 130 active distilleries in Scotland, so there is a lot to choose from. There are five regions that produce whisky, and these regions are Campbeltown, Speyside, Lowlands, Islay, and the Highlands. Sometimes you'll hear mentioned a sixth region, which is the Islands, but most of the time they are wrapped into the Highland region. Where the whisky is made does have an impact on the flavors. So the ones that are closer to the sea, you will get a bit more salty flavor. The ones that are a bit more inland might be a bit fresher, and it all plays a part in the whisky. So I have a Ben Rack, and this is from Speyside. So Speyside is well known for frugal peats and full of fruity flavors. Think apple, pear, honey with a bit of spice. And most of the whiskies in the region are generally put into a sherry cask. Sherry casks are like my favorite type of cask to put whiskey in, because I feel like it gives like that sweet flavor through, and I really just like sherry. Today I'm trying a single malt whisky from Benrach. It is a hidden gem from the area, and they specialize in classic unpeated, Highland peated, and triple distilled. And they craft flavors through the cask that they use, so you know that you're going to be drinking something special here. It was opened by John Duff in 1898 when he bought the Branch farm there. So yeah, it's been around for some time and definitely worth going to visit. And this cute little pack I got, they come with the tasting notes because I'm actually terrible trying to get what flavors come through things. So here it was supposed to get nectarine, honeydew, melon, vanilla, and sponge through the nose. So when you smell it, and then in the palate, it's supposed to come through with kind of baked goods, flavors, kind of think croissants dripped in milk and drinking some coffee. And then the finish is nutty malt, vanilla pods, and apricot remains. It's actually a really good tasting whiskey. I highly recommend this one. The Lowlands are famous for their gentle triple distilled malts and lighter notes that come through the whiskey. Things like lemongrass, ginger, cinnamon, and toffee are some of the flavors that you could see from whiskies in this region. Today I'm gonna try the Glengoyne 12-year-old single malt. It's an entry level whiskey and it won the Lowland Single Malt Whiskey of 2014 and some other whiskey awards. So I'm looking forward to this one. It's a little gem here. Oh, I can smell the saltiness in this. Apparently it doesn't have any salt in it, so I don't know. So the notes are light yet fragrant, fresh cereal with grist of barley sweetness and nutty notes. I definitely got the nutty notes. It's very fruity with notes of Madeira, so I'm assuming it has been put in a Madeira cask, which I do quite like a Madeira. A hint of Calvados and tannic oat lining with the mouth. Yeah, I mean, it's quite a smooth whiskey with a medium strength notes of cereal and fresh greenness. The Highlands is a diverse region and offers lots of flavors. You can get very light malted whiskies to ones that are influenced by the seas. So there is something for everybody's palate in the Highlands. I think that's probably why it's one of my favorite areas to go try whiskey at. Expect subtle oak drams that express their dramatic coastline and moorland whilst leaving rich fruitiness, honey, and occasionally a bit of peat and smoke. Today I'm going to be trying the Glengoyne 10-year-old single malt whiskey. They have a secret waterfall that they source their water for their whiskey from. It was opened in 1833, so it's been around for quite some time, so it's a part of the furniture. All right, swell. Nose. That's actually a very light whiskey too. So this has slightly herbal smell, big bourbon influence. So I'm assuming it was put in a bourbon cask. White milk bottle sweets with more creamy than fruity flavors. Palate is barley, rich, more bourbon influence, clean and dry, and then the finish is long, barley, rich, and a touch of hoisin. So I'm assuming, because I haven't got the information up with me at the moment, that this was aged in a bourbon cask. And fun fact that America only generally uses their cask once, and then they send them over to Scotland because there's the rules and regulations between whiskey and bourbon. Expanding on the islands, most of the whiskies are tinged by the salinity of the seas and taste will vary from island to island. Take Tillisca Skye. This has the very honey and heather notes that come through. And some of the other islands will come through with nutty flavors and a middle ground between sweetness and smokiness. Going over to Campbeltown, their whiskies are varied and full of flavor. Think hints of salt, smokiness, fruit, vanilla, and toffee. They're very robust and full of body. I'm going to be trying a Glengoyne Scotia whiskey today. This is a 15-year-old single malt. Glengoyne Scotia is one of the smallest whiskey distilleries in Scotland, but it's a big name in Campbeltown, so you definitely have to visit. The distillery maintains most of its original features, so the stills and warehouse dating back to 1830. Okay. They're Glengoyne Scotia. So this has, through the nose, lots of rich fruits, apricot jam, satsuma segments, and apple pie. And then the palate is vanilla and fruit with ginger and cinnamon, bringing a subtle dryness. It is definitely a little bit drier than the rest of them. The finish is quite long with a continuing spice. I totally agree, actually. Islay is famous for its fiery and peated whiskies. Now, don't go butchering the name like I do. Sometimes I say Islay, and that is totally wrong, and everyone makes fun of my pronunciations because I totally suck at it. So I do apologize if I've said something wrong in this video, but definitely say Islay so you don't look like a fool, like I have previously. So it's home to the very smoky flavors that come from the peat. And on the south coast, you will find these more intense, and going a bit more inland on Islay, you'll find that they're not as intense as the ones on the south coast. Our Light Lindsay is the whiskey I'll be trying today, and this is from the Character of Islay Whiskey Company. They actually don't distill their own whiskey. They get whiskies from other distilleries and they create their own whiskey. So these can be blended whiskies or single malt whiskies. This is a 10-year-old single malt whiskey that I'll be trying. Their ambition as an independent bottler is to have peat forward whiskies, and they draw their inspiration for creating whiskies based on the island. So anything to do with the island and the people involved, this is what makes their whiskies so special. Oh, I can already smell the peaty smokiness that is coming through. Yeah, nose. Lots of maritime peat with notes of iodine intertwined with honey sweetness, paprika, salted caramel, and old bookshelves. What does old bookshelves taste like? I mean, that is such a weird, like, well, I guess it's a smell. Old books do smell. And then the palate is smoked returns on the inside, mint dark chocolate, espresso, and new leather with honey and soy sauce mixed together. And then the finish is boiled mint sweeties, licorice all sorts, bonfire smoke, toffee penny with a pinch of salt. I would say that, yeah, this is not my style of whiskey. It definitely is a lot stronger in the smokiness and kind of robust flavors, and I tend to go for the lighter, sweeter whiskey. So if you're into this kind of whiskey, then Islay is definitely a place you must visit. Now I realize how easy it is to taste and find good whiskey. It's honestly become one of my favorite pastimes. If you're going to Scotland, make sure that you take one of their tours and experience it for yourself. I'll leave links in the description below of all the whiskies I tried today, and I look forward to seeing you in this video.